Good morning. Welcome to our worship service today. Our opening words come to us from Psalm 8. O Lord, our Sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouths of babes and infants, you have founded a bulwark because of your foes, to silence the enemy and the avenger. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moons and the stars that you have established. What are human beings that you are mindful of them? Mortals that you care for them. Yet you have made them a little lower than God and crowned them with glory and honor. You have given them dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Let us pray. Holiness, word, power, you reveal yourself as one God in three persons, a mighty, creative, life-generating dancer who invites your creation to join you. Catch us up in your love and lead us into your world to call others to follow you with singing and rejoicing. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is Holy, Holy, Holy. Creation displays the glory of God, but our sin keeps us from rejoicing in the love that God reveals. Yet Christ Jesus, the Son, carried our sins to the cross, and the Holy Spirit breathes new life into us, so that we can praise God, our Maker, Savior, and life-giving lover. Let us now confess our sins, that we may receive such grace. Let us pray. Presence, life, fire, God who is three in one, we confess that we have turned away from you. We gaze upon ourselves as if we are worthy of worship. We take your creation into our hands, not to love, but to use and then to discard. We go to the people of the land, not to serve, but to press them into our service. We do not deserve that you would even notice us, but we pray for mercy because you are merciful. Flame of love, purify us from sin. Eternal now, lead us to your truth. Risen One, baptize us into union with you. Transform us into faithful disciples who worship you alone, God who is Trinity. Amen. Friends, hear the good news. The Holy One of Israel, the Redeemer of all the world, and the Holy Spirit who comes as a breath of new life, forgets the sins of all who repent. I declare to you, therefore, that you are forgiven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God, parent to us all. Amen. For the scripture reading this morning, it comes to us from Genesis chapter 1 through chapter 2 verse 4. But instead of reading from the Bible, I am reading a children's book called Let There Be Light. It's a paraphrase of Genesis chapter 1, and it's written by Archbishop Desmond Tutu. If you recall, the Archbishop was an activist during the time of apartheid in South Africa, even imprisoned for the work that he did. He's written several wonderful children's books, and this happens to be one of my favorites. So I share this with you now. Let there be light. In the very beginning, God's love bubbled over when there was nothing else. No trees, no birds, no animals. No sky, no sea, only darkness. Out of this love, God spoke, "Let there be light." And there was day and there was night. And when the first day was done, God smiled and knew that it was good. On the second day, God said, "Let there be sky where the clouds can float and the wind can blow." And the sky was bright blue and beautiful. On the third day, God said, "Let the waters gather together into oceans and let the dry land appear." Now God decided to make the world even more dazzling with tall trees and long grass. And then the first flower opened in all its glory. On the fourth day, God said, "Let the sky be filled with the sun and the moon." And God scattered stars across the sky like sparkling diamonds. On the fifth day, God said, let there be birds to fly and sing, and fish to swim and splash. And the world was filled with the joyous sound of birdsong. On the sixth day, God said, let there be animals, elephants, and giraffes. Cats and mice. And bees and bugs. And suddenly the world was a very noisy place. But something was still missing. Then God said, I will make people, and I'll make them like me so they can enjoy the earth and take care of it. He did just as he had said, and it was also very, very good. God looked at everything that he had made and clapped his hands together in delight. Isn't it wonderful? And on the seventh day, God laughed and rested and enjoyed his glorious creation. You are loved. Friends, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Sing into our ears, O Spirit, the holy word of life. Tell us who we are and to whom we belong, so that we may live with gratitude for all that you have done. Amen. When I was a young child, I was terrified of thunderstorms. Whenever the sky went from sunny to even overcast, anxiety and fear would overcome me. I spent a lot of time in the basement. I would ask my mom, Mom, is there going to be a tornado? And she would say, no, Michael, there's not going to be a tornado. And I said, Mom, is it going to thunder? She said, I don't know if it's going to thunder. Is there going to be lightning? I don't know if there's going to be lightning. So I would go down and hide in the basement until it was all safe to come out. Now, I don't remember how old I was when I attended my first Boy Scout summer camp, perhaps 9 or 10. But I do remember the night when the storms rolled through. Nothing separating me from the storms but a thin piece of nylon. The rain was dripping through the holes in the tent. The lightning lighting up the tent like a strobe light, and the thunder reverberating through my bones. There was something about that night, though, with no place other than my tent to take shelter, having to face the storm head on, and that my fear at that moment turned to awe and wonder. There was something about feeling so small, so helpless against the raw power of nature, that there was nothing more to do but to embrace it and find my place within it. I was thinking about this a few nights ago, following that really hot day. It was either Tuesday or Wednesday. And while watching the protests turn into riots on TV, I also noticed the light show taking place in the distant western sky as storms began moving in off of Lake Michigan. The thunder also sounding off like cannons in the distance. And once again, I was filled with awe and wonder as I thought about how small we really are. I mean, think about it. Within the vastness of the universe, our planet is but a speck among millions. And on this whirling, spinning speck we call Earth, are intricate and violent forces working for and against each other to create a delicate and balanced system that allows life to flourish. And it all began in a void of emptiness and darkness, when God looks into the heart of the darkness and sees something beautiful and hopeful, a creative force, a hovering spirit, and a penetrating light that cannot be overcome. And so God commands these four words, let there be light. And there it was, light. And after there was light, and after the separation of day and night and land and sea, God created the vegetation, the sea creatures and the birds, and the mammals and all the slithering and creeping things on the ground. And yet God still was not finished. God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. In the image of God, he created them. And after God created them, he called his creation very good. Not perfect, but very good. So what does it mean to be created in the image of God? What reflection stares back at you when you catch a glimpse of yourself in a mirror? Do you see eyes that look out into the world with compassion? Do our mouths speak words of mercy and justice? Do our hands commit random acts of kindness? Created in the image of God, we are created not to see differences in race or gender or social status or other isms that are created to separate us, but rather to see the image of God that dwells within each and every one of us. Friends, we were gifted with the responsibility to have dominion, not domination, over creation. To be caregivers, not exploiters. We are called to do unto creation as God has done unto us, and to express love and care toward our neighbor and the entire world. So in our opening psalm this morning, the psalmist is so overwhelmed by the mighty acts of God in creation. He asks God, who are we that you would be mindful of us? And this is where I find myself this week. Who are we that you, O God, would be mindful of us? That you would care for us and love us and be for us? And yet, as small and insignificant as each one of us are, I mean, seriously, think about it. We're just a speck of dust in the universe. And God says, you matter to me. I love you. I call you by name. You are mine. Friends, our nation has experienced almost 2 weeks of civil unrest over the death of George Floyd. And once again, we are being challenged to explore racism, not as individuals so much, but in our social systems and institutions that we are not even aware half the time that we participate in. It's an uncomfortable conversation, and it's easier to shut it down than it is to engage in it. But it's also a conversation that needs to be had. In times like these, actually all the time, we should be asking ourselves, what does God expect from us? Us who have been created in the image of God. The prophet Micah would answer, what does the Lord require of us but to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with God? Now Jesus, who is the perfect image of God, one that we are to emulate here on this earth, teaches us that we are to love one another as I have loved you. So I come before you this day, not with answers, but with more questions. And so I'll offer up a couple of questions for you to ponder about this weekend as we bear witness to the events that continue to unfold across our country before our very eyes. One, what does it mean to be created in the image of God? What does it mean for you? And two, what does it mean to see the image of God in the eyes of the other who is not like you? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come to this table, not because you must, but because you may. Not because you are strong, but because you are weak. Come not because any goodness of your own gives you a right to come, but because you need mercy and help. Come because you love the Lord a little and would like to love him more. Come because he loved you and gave himself for you. Come and meet the risen Christ, for we all are his body. Let us pray. Eternal and triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we give you thanks and praise this morning. In Jesus Christ, you spoke the word that brought the world into being. By the Holy Spirit, you brought order out of chaos and breathed the life into your creatures. In parental love, you stood by us with gracious reproof and welcoming us again into your loving embrace. You are holy, O God, and blessed is Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Born of Mary, he came to dwell among us, full of grace and truth. To all who believed, he gave power to become your children. In ministry among your own, Jesus cared for all, forgiving their failures, healing their hurts, and nurturing their faith, giving himself in utter sacrifice for those he loved. He inspired ordinary people to spirit-filled living and displayed his life, death, and rising again by the power of your Spirit. Remembering your gracious acts in Jesus Christ, we take from your creation this bread and this wine and joyfully celebrate his dying and rising as we wait for the day of his coming. With thanksgiving, we offer you our very selves to you to be a living and holy sacrifice dedicated to your service. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these your gifts of bread and wine, that the bread we break and the cup we bless may be the communion of the body and blood of Christ. By your Spirit, unite us with the living Christ and with all who share this feast, united in ministry in every place. As this bread is Christ's body for us, send us out to be the body of Christ in the world. Nurture us at this table, O God, that we may grow to the stature of Jesus Christ. Help us to love you above all else and to love our neighbors as we love ourselves, demonstrating that love in deed and word toward all your children. Keep us in faithful service until Christ comes in final victory, and we shall feast with all your saints in the joy of your eternal realm. We pray these things in the name of Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, on the night of his arrest, Jesus shared a meal with his disciples, his closest friends. And at that meal, he took bread. And after giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same way, he took the cup, saying, This cup is a new covenant sealed in my blood, poured out for you for the forgiveness of sin. When you drink of it, do so in remembrance of me. Friends, Jesus said, I am the bread of heaven. Those who come to me will never hunger. Those who believe in me will never thirst. Friends, this is the body of Christ given for you. This is a cup of our salvation. Let us drink together in remembrance of him. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, may we who have received the sacrament live in the unity of your Holy Spirit, that we may show forth your gifts to all the world. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew still on the roses, side here, falling on my ear, the Son of God is glorious, and He walks with me, and He talks with me, and tells me I am His own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. He speaks and the sound of His voice is so sweet, the birds hush their singing, and the melody that He gave to me within my heart is ringing. And He walks with me, and He talks with me, and tells me I am His own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever
Eternal Creator calls us, the risen Savior sends us, the dynamic Spirit empowers us. Friends, go into the world making disciples for Jesus Christ. Through baptism, you are one with Christ. He will be with you always. Through baptism, you have received the Holy Spirit. The Spirit breathes into you new life. Through baptism, you are sealed in the love of God, who will keep you forever. Amen.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness God called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky. And there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together God called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind on earth that bear fruit with the seed in it." And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And God said, let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night. And let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. And let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth. And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky. So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves, of every kind, with which the waters swarm, and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters and the seas, and let birds multiply on the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things, and wild animals of the earth of every kind. And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created the humanity, Adam, in God's image. In the image of God, God created him, it, male and female, God created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. God said, see, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, and everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. God saw everything that God had made, and indeed, it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that God had done. And God rested on the seventh day from all the work that God had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work that God had done in creation. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth when they were created.